This lesson will cover the process on how to synchronize the PID with PlantSight and make changes in PlantSight and update the drawing, including on how to use the Visualizer tool to view your PID in PlantSight. The drafted PID was done in the previous session. Next step is to sync it over to PlantSight and to make changes in the PID, then sync the data back to OpenPlant PID, as well as to visualize the PID in PlantSight. Starting with a sync inside of OpenPlant PID, and this will be drawing to PlantSight. Click OK button to start the sync process. And the Drawing to PlantSight Differences dialog will appear showing all the changes. Then, click on Update button and click OK button on the Synchronization Status dialog. Now it is time to switch over to PlantSight in the browser, then access to the project, then start to look at the Tag Management tool in the Data Manager tab that is shown in the tree form. There is the information of project area, service, system, the associated items, and the different component types. Expanding the equipment node. It is sometimes required to refresh the browser if the browser was open. The PID equipment is now appeared. Then click on the Edit Mode button. This will switch to a grid edit mode for the Tag Management tool. Again, Tag Management will be covered in more detail in other lessons. Then, adding a new description for the offloader vessel or the tank, and we will call this offloading surge tank. Next step is tapping out of the field and then click Save those changes. It will save them to the Engineering Document Management tool. And then click on Save Changes button to push these changes into PlantSight. So now that change is done, it updates the tags and PlantSight. Take a look at the vessel, the new description is now updated. Then switch back to the OpenPlant PID and select on the vessel. The vessel properties do not contain a description data yet. Now to initiate a synchronization, select PlantSight to drawing for this time, then click OK button. The sync process runs as before. The Differences dialog appears, and select the specific item to see the changes that was made in PlantSight. In this case is this cone roof tank. It will show the new and old values. Then, click the Update button. The process starts running, and click OK button to complete the sequence. Now, click on the vessel to see that the values from PlantSight have been migrated over and synced into the drawing. So now let's go back into PlantSight to take a look at the visualize capabilities. Click on the Visualizer tool, then switch to the Diagrams tab, and underneath the diagrams is where the PID are stored. Then select the BT2D005 offload PID, and click the Fit View button to see the PID drawing. First, changing the plant structure from modeler to PID, and the PID data will be shown based by the document. Then, expand the PID Documents node and select the Offload PID. Then, select the same tank that was modified previously. PlantSight will actually zoom to the selected vessel and highlight it. If take a look at the functional properties, those are displayed based upon what's in PlantSight. And then if picking on the different components in the drawing, it will load their properties and notice the tree on the left has switched to the same component that was picked in the drawing. Let's select on that surge feed, PID in the tree, and then go to that piping or that pipeline in the piping network system nodes. Then select on the 0104 pipeline, and not only it zooms and highlights that line, but it also loads the respective PID. Continue in the next session on how to create the report in PlantSight.